Hello everyone, I'm Jean, the TCM practitioner and instructor in Victoria, BC, Canada. I update our online class recorder here to help students study and review, prepare for the board exam. The book we used, I write down below, you can check in there. I will update more video later to help students to study. If you like, you can subscribe to my channel and turn on the bell. If some new video coming, you'll be noticed. Okay, let's start.
Okay, let's continue for the diagnosis. We say diagnosis separate with two parts. First part, pick up information, and the second part with the differentiations. So we have a lot of different ways to differentiate the pattern, but basically way, eight principles. Like we can use these pattern diagnoses for all of the case. Yeah. All of the case we can use eight principle diagnosis first. So eight principles means eight aspects. Yin and yang, that's big category. And we separate with external, it belongs to yang. Internal belongs to yin. And heat belongs to yang. Cold belongs to yin. Excessive belongs to yang. Deficiency belongs to yin. So that's generally we're talking about eight principles. So the first thing we talk about external and internal. So external pattern means EPI emitting. Yeah, EPI emitting. Pathogen coming from externally. So that's basically we say EPI. Yeah, EPI. Mainly relationship with like EPI, wind, cold, or maybe wind, heat, or maybe wind, dampness. We say wind bring other pathogens go in. So the typically external pattern, I think we just have our question of return. Fever and aversion to cold same time. That's typically, yeah, typically. And floating pulse. We say, including EPI in cold, in heat, in the dampness, it will be health symptoms. And the other symptoms, a body ache, stiffness of the neck, or maybe even runny nose. So that's the generalized symptoms here. Then we separate external cold and external heat. External cold usually is a wind cold. External heat usually is a wind heat. So they both have aversion to cold, like we're talking about, yeah. They both have floating pulse, like pulse, yeah, floating pulse. And they both have fever, yeah, both have fever. That's both high in the cold pattern and the heat pattern. But some difference. So external cold or wind cold, the pulse is tight. The heat pulse is rapid. Yeah. So we say high rapid pulse is heat. Tight pulse is cold. And for the cold, may make a more severe kind of pain. Yeah, may make a more severe kind of pain. For the heat, maybe let be more sweaty because heat in there. So for the tongue, yeah, for the tongue, we say cold not changing the tongue, yeah, basically. Heat the first 2 days, still not changing. But maybe after 2 days, let be right knees on the side of the tongue, or maybe on the front of the tongue. So that's some difference. Yeah, that's some difference. Being cold, being heat. And thirsty, basically, I still say first 2 days, usually it's not cause thirsty. When people are thirsty, basically, is some heat go to internally already. So that's for the symptoms here. That's basically we say external difference with internal. Internally, basically, is we're talking about internal organs problems, disorder. So that part, mainly we go to organ diagnosis. We go to more detail there. But right now, we just separate with external disorder and internal disorder. And certainly, external disorder usually is acute problems. And the internal disorder, usually it's chronic problems. Then we're talking about the heat and the cold. Yeah, heat and the cold. So when we're talking about the heat and the cold, we will have both excessive heat and deficiency heat, and excessive cold and deficiency cold. So let's talk about the heat condition first. Yeah, heat condition. So heat condition, we say we have excessive heat, or maybe we call full heat, or we also have deficient heat. We also call it empty heat, the same thing. Yeah. So we can from the face, yeah, we can from the face to look here. Excessive heat. Whole face is red. And the deficiency heat just on the cheekbone area is red. And excessive heat, people thirsty and try to drink cold water. But the deficiency heat, they still thirsty, they still try to drink water. But they drink maybe warm water, it's not too hot, it's still not too hot, like body temperature or room temperature kind of water. It's not like ice water, but excessive heat, truly people like ice water. And maybe they drink some water, just a small amount each time, because heat make it thirsty and like to drink. But deficiency make it couldn't handle too much. So that's they drink small amount. And excessive heat, can cause the red eyes, yeah, all over red eyes. Yeah. And including like all over inside eyelids. Usually deficiency heat, not cause that red eyes. Yeah, maybe just let it be in there. And the bitter taste usually coming from excessive heat. Occasionally happens in the deficiency heat, yeah, but most case in the excessive heat. And the patient feel hot, Yeah, feel real hot all day for excessive heat. And the patient feel hot in the evening, yeah, night. That's for decrease heat, like people hot flushing, mostly happens in the night. Excessive heat can cause people high fever. Deficient heat usually causes the low fever, or maybe just the heat feeling there, not truly change body temperature, but people feel hot. And excessive heat is more restless. Yeah, more restless. Deficient heat, sometimes still people feel some restless, but not that severe. That's why we use the anxiety, but still kind of mental unstable there. And excessive heat constipation, yeah. And also cause a painful situation. Deficient heat is more dry stool there, but usually no pain. Excessive heat usually cause bleeding. And the big amount deficient heat, they cause the bleeding still possible, but just small amount. And excessive heat causes the dreams, yeah. And the difficult feel sleep also. Yeah. So deficiency heat is more wake up. Yeah, it's more wake up. But still possible difficult feel sleep. And still possible have dreams. And if they have skin rash, if they cause skin rash, it will be more redness and painful in the excessive heat. And light redness, dark red, or maybe no rash. That's for skin issue. For the tongue. Both have red tongue, but excessive heat with yellow coating, deficient heat may be just thinner, a little bit yellow coating, or maybe just pale tongue, no coating. And the pulse, excessive pulse means stronger pulse, a stronger surging there, rapid pulse. Deficient heat is still rapid pulse, but generally it's deficiency or maybe superficial. When we're talking about pulse, we say yin couldn't hold yang and yang floating. Pulse still possible superficial. Similar like EPI, external saturation, but truly it's internal in deficiency kind of pulse in there. So that's basically about our symptoms, yeah, about the symptoms. Relationship with excessive and deficiency heat here. And the etiology reasons, we have a lot there. Yeah, so that's for heat part. Then we discuss about cold part. Yeah, then we discuss about cold part. So cold part, we still separate excessive cold and deficiency cold. Deficiency cold means empty deficiency, also we call yang deficiency. So they both have pale color, yeah. And they both have aversion to cold, but pay attention here, they don't have fever. If they have fever, they especially go to external cold. But for internal cold, they don't have fever same time. And cold people no thirsty. Yeah. Cold kind of case, people no thirsty. In other words, people thirsty, it must be heat. It's not must be heat. So no thirsty if they are drinking, they are not drinking too much, but if they are drinking, they try to drink hot water. And a cold can make a losing stool. They can make clear urination and in big amount. and the tongue is pale tongue, and white coating and moisting, not dry, and the pulse is a slow pulse. So that's a generally cold, yeah, generally cold symptoms. And there is some difference for excessive cold and defensive cold. We say patient's face is a pale or white color. Excessive cold is more bright red. Defensive cold is more shallow white. And if they cause the painful situation, we say cold always blocking the channels, always cause the painful situation. Excessive cold causes the sharp pain, and it works on pressure. Don't like pressure there. And the defensive cold is dull pain, and better with pressure. Last we talking about symptoms we discussed already. And the excessive cold better after bowel movement, or maybe better with the like a warm tea. Yeah. And the defensive cold is worse after bowel movement or after warm tea. That's the we discussed the symptoms we discussed already. Because of bowel movement, same time, some tea reliefs. Yeah, if defensive in there, it's making the symptoms worse. And excessive urine is something blocking there after bowel movement is released. And the coating, basically pretty similar, white coating there, but excessive cold is a thick kind of tongue coating. Defensive cold is a thin coating. And the pulse certainly totally different. Why is it stronger? Pulse, we're talking about excessive pulse. And the defense is weaker pulse. So that's basically for cold, the cold condition. And some reason cause the excessive cold. People take cold food. People take cold food, make excessive cold inside. Yeah, deeper pulse means internal disorder. So right now we are not talking about external disorder. We're talking about the internal cold, but still possible have excessive cold. And the external cold then go to internally. Like in the beginning is external cold, but gradually penetrated go to internally. That's why the pulse go to deeper. Defensive cold, mainly is yang defensive. So a lot of reasons can cause the yang defensive, and then they cause cold, internal defensive. Then we discuss excessive and defensive kind of condition. Yeah, excessive also fall, defensive also we say empty. So these two conditions, we say that's basically. When we're talking about excessive, we're talking about the passenger. Yeah, passenger. So passenger excessive. And the deficiency, we're talking about the body normal functions. Maybe qi, maybe blood, maybe organs functions is deficiency. We are now talking about some normal qi excessive. So that's basically we separate like excessive condition and defensive condition. From a symptom side, usually excessive condition, like people have big voice, and the breath sounds is bigger and distending, and the feeling is in the chest and the abdominal area, and the pain is worse by pressure. And when they constipations, like mostly it's kind of heat damage body fluid and then cause, or maybe damp heat inside cause. And we're talking about the tongue, we say thin tongue is an excessive condition, thin tongue coating. And pulse is excessive kind of pulse, it's stronger, excessive pulse. The deficiency condition, excessive condition, usually is acute problems. Deficiency condition usually is chronic problems. So for chronic deficiency, we can have a lot of symptoms, relationship with deficiency, and go to different organs and different heart deficiency in there. We have a lot of. They just put something in here, but not like all in here, but we have a lot of deficiency. And usually we talk about deficiency kind of problems. Usually maybe no coating, maybe just a little bit coating there. And the pulse, certainly deficiency pulse. So basically clinically, chronic problems, and some symptoms show up some weakness of the body function, and the pulse is weaker. Thus, we can identify the deficiency. So clinically, sometimes we are not only have excessive pattern or maybe deficiency pattern. Most of the case, especially for a chronic case, they may mix the pattern. So that's even more common compared with only excessive or only deficiency. So our common pattern mix the excessive and deficiency. We're talking about one by one here. So one pattern we talk about the liver yang rising. I think in our case study we talked about a few times already, and even in this class, maybe this class, the multiple choice questions. So remember, liver yang rising is the mixed pattern. Yeah. Means the including excessive part and including deficiency part. So then we use the words liver yang rising. So deficiency mainly is kidney yin deficiency. Possible same time with liver yin deficiency. Because kidney and liver is the mother-son's relationship. And then heat rising up, that's what causes the liver yang rising. It's not only excessive part. That's the excessive part is the bunch, root is the deficiency. And then we have the pattern kidney yin deficiency and the heart with deficiency heat rushing up. So this condition we call it heart and the kidney disharmonized. So when we're talking about heart and kidney disharmonized, remember the pattern is kidney yin deficiency. Usually yang deficiency is people sleep problems. We are not that truly talking about heart and kidney disharmonized. So both in deficiency, kidney in deficiency and heart in deficiency. That's heart and kidney disharmony. Then we're talking about blood, liver blood deficiency, liver yang rising. I think you could include this pattern and go to here together. Yeah, blood, liver blood belong to liver yin. And then liver yang rising. Another pattern commonly coming, spring qi deficiency. Spring qi deficiency, spring function, TNT not working. And the damage of our phlegm mutation, that's a pretty commonly pattern clinically. People show up damage and the phlegm signs, and they also have spring qi deficiency symptoms. And another pattern we're talking about, qi or blood deficiency. Qi not moving can cause the blood stasis. Blood deficiency, blood not moving properly, still can cause the blood stasis. And then we're talking about another common pattern for qin yang deficiency. And then cause the damage. So that's both deficiency and excess. So looking deficiency side, yeah, looking deficiency side. All deficiency side here, we're talking about the normal organ and the normal function deficiency, yin deficiency, blood deficiency, qi deficiency, yang deficiency. And all the excessive part is the passenger. Yeah, liver yang rising is some excessive heat rising up. And the heart deficiency means heart flushing up, still some heat rising up. And the damaged phlegm is the passengers, yes, kind of passengers. Blood stasis is still passenger, damaged. So that's basically we say, when we're talking about the deficiency, we're talking about normal organs, functions, deficiency. When we're talking about excessive, we're talking about different kind of passenger excessive. It's not normal organs, functions, excessive. Any question in this part? Yeah, any question in this part? Okay, so that's we talking about external disorder and internal disorder. And we talking about cold and heat. We talking about excessive and deficiency. So we talking about a little bit more detail about deficiency here. So generally we're talking about the deficiency. We say qi deficiency, yang deficiency, blood deficiency, and yin deficiency. That's the normal body function. So qi deficiency, pale color, yeah, we say pale color can go to qi deficiency. And the people don't want to speak or maybe weak voice, and maybe short breath, that's some key symptoms here. People more tired, or maybe losing stool or appetite. When we go to organ diagnosis, we say we have two organs mainly control all our body qi. One organ is the lung, one organ is the spleen. These two organs certainly easily cause the qi deficiency. But right here, we are not specially go to organ. Basically, we put both qi deficiency symptoms here. Pulse is deficiency pulse. Yeah. So that's a qi deficiency. Then we're talking about yang deficiency. We still have pale face, yeah. And we still have long things to do. We still possible have like a short breath or maybe or appetite plus some cold sides. Cold limbs. And frequent changing the pill to clear. Clear your lesion. People put a pill there, pretty confused. Yes. Changing it to clear your lesion. Yeah. Frequent big amount, clear your lesions. No thirsty just means no heat. Yeah. And still pale tongue and a weaker pulse. So generally say, we can say people qi deficiency, in most case, patient more qi deficiency first. And the later time, more severe, they will go to yang deficiency. And certainly qi belong to yang, qi belong to yang. And the symptoms, yang deficiency symptoms, generally say, is the qi deficiency symptoms plus cold sign. Blood cold sign. So yang deficiency generally say is more severe compared with the qi deficiency. Sometimes clinically we can put together even. We can say yang qi deficiency. So yang qi deficiency still means yang deficiency, still means yang deficiency. If without yang deficiency, usually we just say qi deficiency. So that's qi deficiency means yang deficiency. And blood deficiency means yin deficiency. Pretty similar. So blood deficiency and plus heat size. That will be yin deficiency. That will be yin deficiency. So let's see the symptoms here. So still pale face, pale limbs, and the pale tongue, pale color. That's because blood couldn't nourish. And the bruration, still blood could nourishing for the eyes. And the dry hair, seems similar. Tired, that any kind of deficiency could be tired, not only blood deficiency. And the poor memories, still blood could nourishing. And the numbness or tingling feeling on the limbs. And the people may have insomnia and a scanty kind of period. So all the symptoms is blood couldn't nourish. And the pulse is a more thinner pulse or more choppy because not enough blood moving in the blood vessel to make the pulse choppy and smoothly. Some questions? Then we're talking about yin deficiency. So yin deficiency, we say blood deficiency plus some heat size. And this kind of heat, you usually feel it in the afternoon and the evening. That's more yin time, And in deficiency heat damage body fluid. That caused some dry sound. And can cause the night sweating. That's in deficiency size. Also, we're talking about like a five center heat. And the tongue is right tongue, but without coating, and dryness. The pulse could be floating, empty, yeah, or maybe still thinner and rapid. So that's yin deficiency. Any question in this part? So so basically yang deficiency and yin deficiency, they put a compare here. That's pretty clear, So yang deficiency more cold sense, yin deficiency more heat sense, both belong to deficiency. Then we're talking about a special kind of situation, relationship with yang deficiency and yin deficiency here. We're talking about collapse.
Jin, I have a question.
Yes.
I was reading, I think it was in the case studies book, that so qi deficiency can turn to yang deficiency, but blood deficiency does not turn to yin deficiency. Is that right?
Blood deficiency not directly tending to yin deficiency, but truly yin deficiency, your blood belong to yin part. Severe kind of blood deficiency, still possible tending to yin deficiency. But relationship, like a relationship not like a qi and a yang, not close, but still possible.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So let's discuss yang collapse and yin collapse. So yang collapse and yin collapse, both severe kind of deficiency. Yang deficiency go to most severe, and maybe yin deficiency go to most severe. That kind of condition, we're talking about the collapse. So certainly we still have the same symptoms and the signs like we're talking about yang deficiency, cold inside. Yeah. Cold limbs, people feel cold, yeah, people feel cold. And the yang deficiency can cause the short breath, but the yang collapse is pretty weaker of the breath. And we're talking about yang deficiency. Usually, people not sweating, but yang collapse, people who can get a big amount sweating and kind of a sticky, oily kind of sweating. That's because yang collapse, yang couldn't hold in inside. So that causes sweating, that especially. And urination, yeah, still have frequent urination. And maybe incontinence kind of urination and losing stool or incontinence kind of stool. So that's basically go to yang deficiency. Pulse is more weaker. So minute pulse just means severe kind of weaker pulse. And the tongue still pale tongue, but more swollen and shorter. That's especially go to yang collapse kind of condition. And the yin collapse, So yin collapse, people deficient heat inside is more severe. We say skin hard to touch means most severe kind of heat. And they both have sweaty. Yeah. This kind of sweaty because the heat inside, pushing body fluid coming out. And the whole sensation all over. And generally in degrees, we say people thirsty, but they like drink warm water. But when in collapse kind of condition, they like to drink cold water because too much heat inside, but still in small amount each time. And a dry mouth. And maybe they more holding the urine. They may hold the urine, less urination and the constipation. The pulse, the tongue, right tongue without coating and short and dry. So be careful of pay attention. Short kind of tongue can come in from both young collapse and in collapse. But young collapse is more moist. It's more moisty and swollen. In collapse is more dryness, shorter and dryness. And the pulse, rapid pulse is heat and floating, weaker. So that's about young collapse and in collapse conditions. That's about our eight principle diagnosis. Any question about it, please.